formation of fats. It gives rise to spherosomes. Spherosomes are small spherical bodies which stores fat inside them. It is involved in vitamin synthesis formation as well as in the formation of fat-rich hormones. Now let's move on to the next topic, and that is the Golgi complex. So Golgi complex is also called as Golgi apparatus. It was seen for the first time by George, but it was studied in an intensive manner by Camillo Golgi. That's why it is called as Golgi complex. The dates I have mentioned side by side. Now, it was seen that the Golgi complex can exist in two forms, localized form or a diffused form. Now, what is localized form? Making a rough cartoon only. What is localized form? When you see the Golgi complex is arranged in this manner in a particular place, this is called localized form. Now, sometime what happened? One cisterna is here, then a tubule. Second cisterna is here, so it is present in a diffused manner. So both possibilities are there. If it is localized, it is called as Golgi complex or apparatus. If it is diffused, then the various portions are called as Golgi bodies or Golgisomes, or in plants it is called as dictyosomes. Golgi apparatus is similar to the ER, is made up of cisternae, tubules, vesicles, and one more thing, Golgian vacuole. Golgian vacuole. Cisternae basically are 6 to 8 and they are curved in this manner. So one face is of them is convex, the other face is concave. Now I've drawn the similar picture here. Every cisterna will carry a convex face followed by a concave one. So they are all present next to each other in concentric manner. The convex face is always towards the nucleus. This is the differences which are basically asked in the exams also. So please be clear with this. The face which is closer to the nucleus is called as the cis face. Also is shaped as a convex shape. It is also called as the formative face, also called as forming face, and it is also called as the proximal. Proximal means close to the nucleus. The opposite face is concave, maturing, trans, closer to the plasma lima, away from nucleus. That's why it is called as distal face. Even the thickness of the membrane, this membrane is thin, thicker, and maximum thick. So as it comes closer to the plasma membrane, they are becoming thicker. Similarly, the lumen size, the cavity size also increases. There are many holes present. Holes are called in biology as fenestrae or fenestrations. There are fenestrations present in cisternae, tubules, and they are responsible that when they are formed at the sidewise, they will develop into tubules, and then transition vesicles also develop from there. Golgian vesicles. Transition vesicles develop by the ER. Imagine for a second that there is a vesicle pinching out from here. Cisternae are linked with the tubules in ER, and a vesicle coming out from here. This vesicle, which is full of enzymes or proteins, things to be modified, are packed up inside a sac which is called as vesicle. This vesicle can also be called as transition vesicle. So a transition vesicle from the ER will fuse into the convex face of the Golgi body, undergoes changes and come out from which side? The side which is concave in shape. And when it comes out, it will be called as a Golgian vacuole, or otherwise called as the Golgian vesicle. I hope this much is clear to you, students. We'll carry on from lysosomes and vacuole in the next class. Thank you.